After shooting the legal step on the last Tuesday, today we come up with a Domino defense. Domino defense is a very ancient defense, and let's see how white can do the Domino defense against the black. Let's say white started with the e4. Black goes for the e5, knight to f3 and pawn to f6. This is the biggest blunder if black is moving its pawn to the f6. So many grandmasters and so many opening videos says for a black, never go for the f6. If knight captures on the e5 and pawn captures the knight, queen to h5 is a check. Black pawn moving g6 and try to protect the black king and also attacking on the queen. But queen to e5 is a check to the king and also rook is under attack. Even though queen to e7 defend the kings for a while, but white queen beautifully captures the rook on the h8. On the sixth move of the game, white is ahead with the rook. Now let's see, instead of moving its pawn to the g6, black decided to move its king to the e7. So again, queen to e5 is a beautiful check. Now from here, wherever black king tries to run, we can give number of check, continuous checks to the black king. King moves to f7, so bishop to c4 is again check, king goes to the g6, but queen to f5 is again a check with the support of pawn. Kings try to go to the h6, now pawn to d4 or the d3, again give one more check to the black king. Black move its pawn to the g5 and defending himself from the check, but the pawn to h4, it's again a one more attack on the pawn. Suppose black moves bishop to protect this pawn, but pawn captures the pawn on the g5, it's a double check. Pawn and rook both is giving the check to the king. Now king goes to the g7 and queen to f7 is a beautiful checkmate. So in the 11th move, white did checkmate to the black king. So we have to be careful before defending the h5 check. So when queen to h5 and try to give the check to the black king, if you realize black don't have a much option. Black have only two options, is either pawn to g6 or queen to the e7. So that's only two options black have. So you have to be very careful and you cannot run away with the king in the center. Okay, but if you still want to defend or deal with somehow this mistake, then maybe you have to sacrifice your rook by moving your pawn to the g6 and queen gives check from the e5 and also attack on the rook. That's the only and best possible move from the here. If you still want to come up with solution, then whenever you see that you have moved your pawn to the f6, if you see that pawn, you have just moved your pawn to the f6 and now you cannot take it back. So it's okay, even though knight captures the e5 pawn, don't go for the capturing the knight. Simply move your queen to the e7. So now pawn and queen both is attacking on the knight. Suppose bishop moves to the c4 and try to attack on the f7 square with the bishop and knight, then you can simply capture the knight. After queen to the h5, instead of moving its pawn to the g6, king moves to the e7, queen captures the pawn and giving check, king goes to the f7, and now bishop goes to the c4 and giving one more check. Previously we were discussing about king to g6, but instead of going king to the g6, what if the pawn goes to the d5 and try to protect the king from the check? Then bishop captures the pawn on the d5, king goes to the g6. Now the problem is now queen cannot go to the f5 because bishop is protecting on the f5 square. So instead of moving your queen to the f5, we have to go for the pawn to h4. So now black has to move its pawn to the h5 because if again pawn goes to the h5, that's a one more check will become. Okay, so black has to move its pawn to the h5. Now there's a very interesting move comes from here. Now bishop goes to the b7. This is a called deflection because the black bishop is protecting the f5 square. White bishop goes to the b7 and attacking on the bishop and the rook. So if black bishop try to capture the white bishop, then we have a chance to attack on the f5. So black bishop has to do that, otherwise white can simply capture the bishop. So now again, white queen to the f5, give one more check. King to h6. Now we move our pawn to again d4 and try to give check with the black bishop. But now pawn can go to the g5 and stop the bishop attack. There are so many different variations from here. But very interesting checkmate we can do is queen to f7. Because now whatever black do, the checkmate will come. Instead of doing anything, let's see, queen goes to the e7 and inviting white queen for the exchange. But pawn captures on the g5, it's a beautiful checkmate. Let's remember this one, the black pawn cannot capture the white pawn because it's already pinned. So pawn capture on g5, it's a check. Queen capture the g5 pawn, but rook to h5, it's a beautiful checkmate because now queen is pinned, so queen cannot capture the rook. So it's a checkmate in 40 moves.